principal component analysis or PCA is a dimension reduction technique. Let me remind you what we are doing in PCA without using any technical jargons. In PCA, we project our higher dimensional data to a new coordinate system. And then we pick only a few of those new coordinates that explains most of the variation in the data. That's how we reduce the dimension. In this video and another one, I will explain the mathematical basis of PCA. I have a data matrix X. We have n number of samples and d variables. Each column for one variable. The samples are in rows. In PCA, we want to project this data on a vector with a condition or constraint. This vector will be a principal component. I will discuss the condition or constraint later, but first the issue of projection to the vector. To understand projection of the data, I will take a small example. I have a two-dimensional system with two variables, x and y. And so I have two samples. Capital X is my data matrix. The first sample is x1, y1. I want to project this data on a vector u. Suppose this arrow is the u vector. And that orange circle is sample 1. And its projection on u is that orange triangle. The formula of scalar projection will give me the position of that triangle on u. So P, the projection of sample 1 on vector u, is equal to the dot product of x1 and u divided by the length of u. X is the data vector for sample 1. To make the calculation simple, consider u is a unit vector. That does not affect much of our calculation, as we are only interested to know the position of our data in the direction of the vector u. Unit vector will anyway give us that direction. When u is an unit vector, the projection is just dot product of x1 and u. Let's calculate the dot product. Suppose u is a 2x1 vector with elements p and q. Our data has two variables. It is a two-dimensional data. So the vector u that we use for projection is also a 2x1. By dot product, I get a scalar value. P into x1 plus q into y1. That is the position of sample 1 on span of u. Here, note one important point. This new position of our data is coming from the linear combination of x1 and y1, the old coordinates. That is why PCA is a linear technique. This way, I'll also get the projection of sample 2. That is quite easy. Now, let me generalize the same for a bigger data matrix of n by d size. X is my data matrix, u is the unit vector. X is an n by d matrix. I have d number of variables and n number of samples. So, u is a d by 1 vector. The projection of x on u is obtained by the dot product of x and u. Both x and u has the right dimensions. I do not have to take much trouble. A simple multiplication of x and u will give me the dot product. That multiplication gives me a vector with n elements. This vector is the projected data. The entries of these vectors are the new positions of n samples on the span of this unit vector u. Fine. XU is the projection of X on U, an unit vector. X is given, but how will I get the U? Now comes the condition that we apply for PCA. Project the data on a vector such that the variance of the projected data is maximum. That means I have to project the data X on a vector u in such a way, I have to choose the vector u such a way that the variance of the projected data is maximum. Our projected data is x times u. So what I'm asking you to do is that choose an u that maximizes the variance of x times u. You know how to calculate the variance of a random variable. But here we have matrix and vectors, and we are calculating the variance. So I will discuss how to get the variance of XU. But first, we will learn about covariance matrix. Again, I will take a simple example. My data set X is 2 by 2. Two variables, X and Y, and two samples. The variance of X would be 1 by n into summation of xi minus x bar square. Here n is 2. Similarly, the variance of y will be summation of yi minus y bar square divided by n. We also know the formula for covariance between x and y. So the covariance between x and y is equal to 1 by n into the summation of xi minus x bar into yi minus y bar. Now I want to calculate these variances and covariances not just by this type of summation but using matrix operation. For that calculation, I need xi minus x bar and yi minus y bar. Here x bar and y bars are the mean. So I will subtract x bar from all entries of x in the data matrix. Similarly, I will subtract y bar from all the entries of y in the data matrix. In this way, I will get a new matrix. And this matrix is called a centered matrix. We have standard tricks for matrix algebra to get this matrix. As this matrix is called is a centered matrix, I have used C in the subscript of X. I need the square of this centered value to calculate the variances. So I will multiply the transpose of XC with XC. Try this multiplication yourself. This will give us all the square terms and summations. So we have the summations of the square terms. But to get the variance and covariance, I have to divide these terms by n. So I divide this matrix by n. The resulting matrix is called the covariance matrix. Let's see what we have in this matrix. The diagonal element of this matrix are the variances of x and y. And the off-diagonal elements are identical and they are the covariance of x and y. Notice another interesting feature. This matrix is square and symmetric. Now from a two-dimensional system, I generalize the covariance matrix for a d-dimensional system. For data X, the covariance matrix S is equal to 1 by n into XC transpose XC. XC is the matrix X after centering. Now data centering is done by default in PCA. So I'll drop the subscript C. So the covariance matrix S is equal to 1 by n into X transpose X. From now on, by X, I mean centered data. Let's check some properties of the covariance matrix. It is a square matrix. Our data has D variables. So S, the covariance matrix, is a D by D matrix. It is also a symmetric matrix. The diagonal elements of this matrix are the variances. And the off-diagonal elements are covariances. Now, variances are always positive. So, the trace of this matrix is positive. More interesting for us in PCA are the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of S. All eigenvectors of S are orthogonal to each other. That is because S is a symmetric matrix. This property is very useful in PCA. If n is greater than d, that is the number of samples is more than number of variables, and all columns of x are linearly independent, then S has d positive eigenvalues. Note that with these two conditions, S has the full rank and the rank is d. But when n is less than d, the rank of S is less than d and S will have at least one zero eigenvalue. With this condition, we can have at max n minus 1 positive eigenvalues. This will happen when the number of samples is less than the number of variables. Obviously, it is wiser to avoid such circumstances. I'll stop the video here. The mathematical formulation for PCA is still half cooked. I'll complete that in next video. But I prefer that you go through what we discussed in this video a few times. Here, we have learned two important topics. Projection of data on a vector, particularly on a unit vector, and covariance matrix. Take some time to understand these two with clarity and then move to the second video. Thank you.